From Netflix, Mike Flanagan crafts a wholly unique haunting experience in this 10-episode horror series, The Haunting of Hill House. This series follows the Crane family, who move into their mansion in the early 90s, where the goal is to flip and sell the house using its profits to build their forever home. Soon after moving in, however, the family, particularly the children, fall prey to its paranormal activity and only flee when tragedy occurs and their mother mysteriously dies. Episode 6, Two Storms, centers around two nights. Present day, Shirley's funeral home for Nell's wake, yet another tragedy, and in the 90s at Hill House when another storm occurs and Nell goes mysteriously missing. Episode 6 particularly strikes viewers to their core as the Cranes reuniting for Nell's wake brings forth a brutal force of grief, boiling over in ways only those familiar with loss will recognize. This is counterhegemonic to Hollywood film, as the intensity of grief is rarely shown in popular media. In fact, each of the five siblings represents the five stages of grief. Steve represents denial.
My mother saw it too, and anything I did, I did it for a very good reason.
Offensive, all this bullshit.
Well, you want to hear this or not?
Haunted house, and you don't
what,
even
Steve?
Get it.
I don't get it.
You don't get it. You're the ghost.
Shirley represents anger.
I mean, two of us. There were seven of us, and now there's five, because two of us decided to die.
Theo represents bargaining as she tries to drink her sister back to life. Luke represents depression as he spends most of his life using drugs as a way to escape the horrors of Hill House. And Nell represents acceptance as she fully acknowledges the horrors that went on in the house. This embodiment of grief is counterhegemonic as each character stays in a particular stage for the majority of the show, whereas Hollywood tends to paint grief as a one-and-done deal. Filmed in only five long takes, 114 minutes long, the effect is suffocating as we watch in real time as the Crane family bite at their mutual insecurities and share grief.
Theo's drunk, I'm just pissed. And this is the part of the show where you break out my goddamn
talk
book.
Talk about propagating delusions.
Oh, why don't we just
take a step back? Let's just take a step back.
There we go.
Okay?
I thought we were going to make.
What about that? Huh? You took all that paranoia and craziness and you mass marketed it to jumpstart your writing career.
Really?
So don't stand in plain view of Nelly's casket and lecture any of us
are
about
you guys gonna
responsibility
stop the
or truth. Well, you were happy enough to exploit all of us for some blood money. That's why none of us ever took your fucking money, Steve.
Cut it out.
And you're fucking drunk.
The single shot effect sucks the viewer into the action, subverting both space and time, providing seamless transition that brings memory into the present, intensifying the character's emotions, as well as the viewer's emotions. Though this deep penetration of raw emotion may be hegemonic in an international film, Hollywood rarely takes these risks with emotions, toying with its audience with these long takes, and therefore, The Haunting of Hill House forces us to contend with our own buried thoughts, emotions, traumas, and grief.